Hello, my name is Ragnar Pedersen. I'm a scientist at the European Food Safety Authority. I'm here to talk to you about pesticides and how they get into our food. Pesticides are used to protect crops from disease and infestation. They're considered important for protecting harvests and ensuring our food supply. All pesticides contain active substances. These are the essential ingredients that enable them to function. This can be a chemical or it can be a micro-organism, such as a bacterium or a virus. In some cases, the chemical works by confusing insects. In other cases, they make the crop less palatable for pests. But commonly, they work by killing the damaging insects, weeds or fungi. Pesticides can be widely distributed in the environment where they could be harmful to plants and animals. In some cases, small amounts called residues can find their way into the food that we eat. These residues could be harmful if they exceed certain levels. There are many ways in which pesticide residues can get into our food. For example, residues in treated crop can be carried from the field to the food on our table. Residues can get into the water supply, or they can contaminate soil or animal feed and so find their way into our food indirectly. A pesticide can only be put on the European market if it has been scientifically established that it can be used safely. This means that it can be used without harmful effect on humans or animals, and that it does not damage the environment. Crucially, the amount of pesticide residue in food must be as low as possible, and the food must be safe to eat. This is maintained through maximum residue levels, which are legally enforced and monitored. In Europe, around 67,000 food samples are analysed for pesticide residues each year. The European Food Safety Authority works together with scientists from across Europe to assess the evidence and provide independent scientific advice. Based on this advice, the European Commission decides whether an active substance is approved or not approved. In 1993, before the current approval process, there were around 1,000 active substances on the market. Of these, the European Commission approved some 250. The remainder are no longer on the market. This helps ensure the safety of our food.